Yes, Python has a ternary operator. The ternary operator, in many languages since 1960, has looked something like this, using the question mark. But Python is way too cool for that, so in Python, it's written using if. And to top it all off, it's not even referred to as a ternary operator, even though it totally is. Instead, an expression like this in Python, a if some condition, else b, is technically referred to as a conditional expression. But anyone will know what you mean if you say ternary operator or if expression. Side note, why is it called ternary and not trinary? I don't know, maybe if you're an English expert, you can comment down below and I'll pin the answer. The way it works is it first evaluates the condition, and then if it's true, gives you the first thing, otherwise the second thing. This is kind of out of order of the way that it's written, but it's more in line with how you might say it out loud in English. The value is x if x is bigger than 0, otherwise negative x. A lot of different alternatives were considered, but they literally held a vote, and this if syntax won out over using a question mark. But importantly, the condition is the first thing that's evaluated, and the expression that's not returned doesn't get evaluated at all, which is important in a case like this, where we don't want to divide by 0. It's a similar idea as short-circuiting for and an or. It's basically just syntactic sugar for a full if statement, but it also returns a value. And keep in mind that this is Python, and in Python, it usually doesn't check whether a value is literally equals equals true. Instead, Python uses its notion of truthiness, where something like a non-empty list would be considered true, but an empty list would be considered false. In general, it's good for short definitions, like setting the default value of a mutable argument. But do your best not to go overboard, it quickly becomes unreadable if you try to stuff too much stuff into one expression. And just like with any other operators, beware of operator precedents. Where you put or don't put parentheses can change the answer. The ternary operator has the lowest precedence of any operator in the language, so the parentheses, if you were to put them in, look like this. Now for the surprising part, the Stack Overflow answers for this question. Luckily, the first answer is the one that I would recommend, but number 2 with over 900 upvotes, and number 3 with over 400 upvotes, tell you to do something completely bonkers. These answers are from 2008 and 2009. Back when these answers were written, they served a completely legitimate purpose, but today they should not appear anywhere in your code. I wish Stack Overflow had a way to flag an answer as severely out of date without hurting the reputation of the original poster. After all, if you tried to ask this question again today to get a modern answer, it would surely be closed as a duplicate.